stood there. Notice what Jesus said to him in verse 34. Now when Jesus saw that he answered wisely, he said to him, "You're not far from the kingdom of God." And you think about this guy, this scribe, he's been put up to this by the Pharisees. But in the face of the Pharisees, he makes that comment to Jesus. Because he was honest at heart, he recognizes that Jesus was right on the money. He didn't just walk away. He comments on, "You're right. You're absolutely right." And Jesus says to him, "You're not far from the kingdom. You're really close. I'd like to know. I want to know when I get to heaven. Is this one of the people who chose Jesus?" By the way, it was out of the Pharisees that a large number came to Jesus. Interesting, isn't it? From the Sadducees, very, very few ever accepted Jesus. But out of the Pharisees, a large number came. I'd like to know whether this guy did. Then we come to the last part, what John David was reading about. Jesus then, these Pharisees are all around him, watching, trying to catch something that they can use. And so Jesus turns to them and says, "While the Pharisees were gathered together, Jesus asked him, saying, 'What do you think about the Christ? Whose son is he?'" Whose son is he? And you notice, turn back just a few pages to Matthew 15:22. Jesus had gone up to Tyre and Sidon, and up there there's this woman that comes to him and says, "Have mercy on me, O Lord, son of David. My daughter is severely demon-possessed. Have mercy on me, O Lord, son of David." This is a non-Jew, and recognized him by that name, son of David. The Jewish people had a belief that the Messiah, when he comes, will be known as the son of David. They proclaimed it. It's in Scripture. The Old Testament uses that term often for the Messiah. The Messiah that's coming, he will be the son of David. Even this non-Jew knew that and used that term for him. So, okay, Jesus now asked the Pharisees, "What do you think about the Christ? Whose son is he?" They said to him, "The son of David." Interesting how these guys are trying to trip him up every way you can think of. He asked him a question and they popped right back. "The son of David." In fact, that probably rang out all around him. All these people. "This is the son of David." And he said, "How then does David, in the Spirit, call him Lord?" By the way, when it says "in the Spirit," how then does David in the Spirit? That means by the Holy Spirit speaking through him. Prophetically speaking. "Call him Lord, saying, 'The Lord said to my Lord, sit at my right hand till I make your enemies your footstool.' If David then calls him Lord, how is he his son?" When you go over to the Philippines, And you see this in a lot of other cultures. But if you go over to the Philippines, you'll notice that over there, everybody needs to know how old you are. You respect your elders. And even if you're two people that are very close in age, they'll want to know when's your birthday. You got to know which one is the oldest. Do I have to show you respect, or do you have to show me respect? It's something that we don't really grasp in this country. It's not a part of our culture like that. But it is very strong in their culture, and it was in the Jewish culture. Very strong in the Jewish culture. So he's saying, how is it that David, now the Messiah is the son of David, how is it that the Messiah, that David calls the Messiah Lord? That was unheard of in their culture. And yet, that's what's happening. He's saying this to them. You need to be called, you need to think about that. If this son of David is Lord, it's because he existed before him, before David. That's why they called him Lord. He is God.
Amen.
He is God. He's not just the son of David. He is God. We've been talking today about how people look at Jesus. We've been talking about how they saw him. What kind of a lens did they use? What was their world view? We have a number of different world views presented today. What's your world view? Do you see Jesus with a clear lens? When you read the scriptures, are you getting a true picture of Jesus? If you're not, you're going to have a distorted view. These guys had a distorted view. My prayer is that each one of us have a clear, sharp view of who Jesus is and how we should be serving him and how we should be used by him as we minister to God. Our closing hymn today is hymn number 327. I'd rather have you know. Hymn number 327.